Hello and welcome to Let's Play Nephise, Ascension, Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. This is the latest and so far the last and latest game in the Nephise series. This one looks like it might be a little different, a little more interactive. So this is another game by Tonguç Bodur. I know I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. Check out the statue there, I just noticed that. So yeah, I'm really enjoying these short games. This one might be a little longer. And settings, a little different this time. We have force feedback for the controller, but I'm not using a controller, so I turn it off. I'm sure it doesn't make a difference in any case. Subtitles I put on. Mouse sensitivity I had to put all the way down. I don't know if it's my mouse or it's just the way these games are. If it's any higher than this and I turn the mouse and we're whipping all over the place. So I know it's kind of hard to watch when that happens. I can't go any lower than 1%. 0% means I cannot move the mouse. Well, I can, although the game won't respond to it. So, and now we have toggle cross here. And we have run in this one. I had to put everything down to 40%. I mean, maybe the music could be a little louder, but the voice definitely should not be any higher than this. So you can hear me over it in case of unexpected circumstances. Stuff. Oh, unlimited? 60. It didn't save that. I know I had this set to 60 frames per second. Graphics, these were all on Ultra by default. Just checking this. Hold on a second. See that? 60 frames a second. What was it on just display? Unlimited. It won't save that. It won't save the frames per second limit. Alright, whatever. So anyway, we're doing a new game, obviously. Another game. We can't save during these, so you just play the whole thing through. Shouldn't take that long. An hour, maybe two. Something like that.
Nephise was a young orb collector. One day, while searching for orbs, she got lost and fell down a hole into Dragon's Valley.
A hole.
The only exit was via the high grounds, but there was no easy way up there. She came upon a vast lake. She unmoored a boat near to the shore and sailed it to the other side of the valley.
Now here's one change that's momentary. You can actually see somebody. So this is Nephise. Hello there. Look at her breasts, though. The way they moving. I know I kind of ruined it there. Otherwise, it's perfect. I love it. I might make that into the thumbnail. Because I really couldn't find a good thumbnail. So, another thing I noticed. We can't get back on the boat or go in the water. Otherwise, this happens. The water hurts. So you could run, and it's a toggle. So you're running, running, and then toggle off. And the crosshair, we can turn on and off. I'll leave it off for now. Nice, I didn't notice that. Definitely got some blur going on. I don't like that. I don't like that much. But there's no option in the graphics to change that, right? Sorry, I know. The song I love, actually, by the way. I mean, resolution window mode. Graphics. Textures, shadows, anti-aliasing, post-processing, and effects. Nothing about motion blur or anything like that. So, I mean, this is a motion blur effect, is it not? I'm not even sure. So, we can't go in the water. We die in agony. So all I play, this is blind, I just went up to the edge of the dock and stopped. And I sat here and listened to the music for a few minutes because I freaking love it. It's beautiful yet mysterious. I love it. I want to find out about who made it. I want to find out. It almost sounds like at one point she's saying Nephise. Like here. It's like Nephise. So I don't know, maybe. So I kind of like want to find out who composed this and everything. We'll run now. What do we have here? Is that an orb for us to collect? So I really actually don't mind at all if this song plays the entire game. It might. But who knows, maybe the next song will be every bit as awesome. That's a bunny! There's a bunny-sh! Can I collect the bunny? Does it? I don't collect the bunny. It's still there. Aww. I keep stepping. Is that a tiny pig? I don't think we can't strafe, so I can't walk. Or is it just a bunny, just a different color? It looks like a bunny, just a different color. Okay. So they give us a run option, maybe just more ground to cover now. Oh, it's singing! It's singing to me! What's up on here? Can I jump on here? I want that! My orb! I collect orbs. I don't know why. I'll go get it later. Right now we got Stonehenge over here. My view of the lake. So she fell down a hole and ended in this valley. What hole? Who falls in a hole and ends up in a valley? Usually you would end up like in a sewer or something, or a construction site, a dungeon, a cave, but not in a valley after falling through a hole. Awesome, look at this. Pass through the portal. Vroom. It's all the way over there. Okay, we continue this way for a little while. Oh! I can't strafe. Did the other games strafe? This turns, which is... No. Come back. I like strafing because you turn with the mouse, obviously. So are you gonna... Come here. It's too high. I gotta jump and get it, right? Is that the challenge? It's obviously faster than I am. I don't get stuck on stuff. Get back here! Alright, what's this? I want to jump on things. I just really can't jump on that. Oh, okay. Look, it dipped low, like we can get it. Look how it lights up the rocks, though. I love it. These orbs are very elusive. But you can see where they are because they light up the whole area. Jump! Jump! It's gotta be... Do they settle down somewhere? I can't get that. This one one of them passed right by here, like, twice. So maybe if I just wait and jump up... Is that one coming back? You coming? You coming? I thought it was gonna pass right over me. And then I could jump up and get it. Now, yeah, there's no first person mode. We can't change camera and see Nephise running around. I would do it, believe me. Ugh. I really don't know. Okay, let's go up and see what's up here. You know, I could stand around all day waiting for those things to come by or waiting to try to grab them. And I mean, if you're in the right... I don't know. I don't know if it's possible to grab them. A bird, yeah. One's over there. It's too high. They might be taking different paths because I'm standing here. Which means they're intelligent. Oh, damn, it just went right. Can I climb this stuff? What? What? No! This one dipped down here. No. I'm really wondering if you can catch them, if it's possible. What good is an orb collector? You can't collect orbs, right? I want it. I want that. So obviously we saw there's a cave, but I want to look around the rest of this, see if there's anywhere else to go. Anything else to see? Interact? No. Really? Oh, look at that! So what is this from? This is from a dragon. Well, we're in Dragon's Valley. It makes sense that there would be a dragon, right? Hence the name. Okay. Now, for some reason, unlike the other two games, someone right over there lighting up the area. I can't record this. I have to record this in desktop mode. So, it's not running in DirectX or something? I don't know. So that's another difference from the first two games, in my perspective anyway. So hopefully the graphics look fine. Just seeing all that there is to see. So the orbs don't really come back here. If that's what they are. Maybe they're not orbs at all. That's something that just looks a lot like an orb. Bet you I can't jump on that. Not quite. Wait. Come here. Come here! Damn you! I love how it lights up the trees and everything around it. I'm not gonna catch this thing. Now there's one that ducks down low around here somewhere. I don't know if this is the one or if this is the place where that happens. Have I been over here? It's very foggy over here. Oh yeah. That's where the skeleton is. Oh, wait. Is that where it dips down? Over here? The thing is, I wonder if they all take the same path as one back there. Or if they each have their own path. So it went like right around here, right? Sorry guys, I know we've accomplished nothing. Let's just see if it comes back. So all I know is that apparently there's some light puzzle elements and some platforming. Jeez, Mr. Bodur, what are you doing? Did I just miss that? Did it just go right by me? Okay, it comes out of here. I can't strafe. So right above me here. Watch it like avoids me, right? Just waiting for it. And I guess we'll go to that cave. If they really wanted you to catch it, they put strafe in the game, wouldn't they? One there, one over there. Actually, two. Okay. Well, it goes back there first, though, doesn't it? That one really didn't come over here. Okay. Okay, it's going back over there. I don't know, it might be an achievement or something like that if I get one of these things. I don't know. I don't have the achievement window thing up. Ugh. No, I can't get it. Alright. I'll be chasing these things for hours. And then they make their own little tinkling sound. I love it. So yeah, the other games, I know I don't have a window up for anything, but I have gotten all the achievements for it. Which isn't a lot. 3 out of 3 Steam achievements. Now the funny thing is, I just realized, looking at the games, Nephise and then Nephise Begins were released 1 month apart. Butterflies. And then this was released basically like 9 months later, April, and then February of the next year. So that's why it's different. I want it. Now, where did I think it went further? That was over there, but I've been there. Okay, that's it. So we're gonna go in that cave. I've blasted like 22 minutes already. I just want that. Where's the cave? I keep trying to strafe around this stuff. Good question. I thought it was right in the base of this or something. It's over here then? No. Maybe around here? Oh, there's light coming from it. I got it. So, the idea of this game is to basically advance and escape this valley? Dragon's Valley? Apparently now we have some way that we can fail and be returned to a previous spot? Something like that? And now, notice, when you fall from jumping, you make a sound. Well done. That's been bothering me. Sweet. Splashing sounds. Are we going in here? No. Okay. I have a statue. What am I supposed to do with it? Fishies! There's fishies. Wow. Nice effects. I'm supposed to put the statue somewhere? Maybe outside? was somewhere in here to go advance further. Look at the texture. It's really nice. I'm just gawking at everything here. How am I supposed to put it here? I'm not supposed to step there, are I? There's nowhere else to jump to. Maybe I go out here and it'll open one of those doors. Back to the Song of Awesomeness. So I don't know where to put this thing. But there are some platforms, but maybe I'll try to put it on one of those. Clicking. What? I was right. So where did it turn? It looked like it was over here, but I don't remember there being a door here. Or I was just assuming it was up here. I don't remember there being a door here. It might be back behind me. I'm headed this way, so I'll just go check over here. Yeah, there was nothing here, right? The Great Tree of Awesomeness. So let's go back. It's either one of those two doors. For some reason thinking it's that door over there, but I might as well just check this one, and it's open, okay. Does it open all of them? That's a good question. Somewhere we have another door or two to explore. Whether they have to be opened or not.
She headed towards the Dragor Temple.
Oh God,
there was another statue here, but Nephise felt too weak to carry it. She needed to collect some orbs first, so that she could bear the statue's burden.
Okay, so these orbs I guess we'll be able to collect. Why does her chest move like that? I mean, it would be perfect otherwise. So I noticed they turned our little thingy on. Which one is it? This one. I guess it helps us collect the orbs. More bunnies. Hopefully these orbs are not as elusive as the others. And obviously we have 10 to get. Seriously, thank you. They don't tinkle though. They make their own little sound. They're just kind of quiet and kind of there. You hear that sound? I was like, yeah, knocking it out of the park. Orb City, man. Boom. There's another area back there. Check it in a minute, I guess. This music is nice too. Yeah, I'm gonna turn this off. Don't think it's needed. Oh, nice. Hello.
Nephise remembered the first time she encountered an orb. Inside the Harpy's dark temple.
Yep.
More importantly, she remembered how the orb gave strength not only to herself, but to her sister, Lula, who had fallen ill some months previous. Alas, the power of that one orb only benefited her sister for a day or two before she was bedridden once again.
So the orb gave her strength and also gave her sister strength somehow. And yes, they're referring to when she caught her first orb, the events in Nephise Begins. Oh, I didn't think that would happen. Oh, it goes back down if we don't move. Let me collect some more orbs. Oh wait, 6 out of 10. All right. I mean, maybe some are up there that have to be collected. Here's another one though. And then we'll go up there. I love the blue flame. Or turquoisey flame, whatever. I saw an orb. Oh, I can't climb that. Oh, I can. Okay, so that just leads back here. Is that the orb over there? Or is that just light? Oh, that's where the platform is. Go on the platform, bunny. You can go up. You want to go up? Alright. I just want to look around for more auras before I start going on platforms and little escalators of magicness. So we came from there, I think, right? So I don't want to leave, actually. So actually, I think we're done in this area. This is all closed off. All right. So one more check around. We got, whoops, wrong button. 7 out of 10 orbs. Oh, I really can't. Really? Okay. I'll go around. She's not good at climbing, is she? I'm running up slopes. Here we go. The music ran out. Like, no one would spend this long in this area. Don't know me that very well. Alright. Okay. We go up. I cannot move while the thing's in motion.